My dearest Aileen, what a journey these past 5 years have been. First time we met, I was terrified to sing and dance in front of you. But now, I will openly sing, dance, fart, be stupid, be funny, be angry, all at the same time. I've made you laugh, cry, sad, be mad. These are all the good and bad times. These are the emotions and memories that showed me who you are as a person. I love it all.
John, do you take Aileen to be your wedded wife? And in the presence of these witnesses, do you vow that you will do everything in your power to make your love for her a growing part of your life? Will you continue to strengthen it from day to day and week to week with your best resources? Will you stand by her in sickness or in health, in poverty or in wealth? And will you shun all others and keep yourself to her alone as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Good evening to beloved family and friends of John and Aileen. My name is Avalyn. Together with me, other bridesmaids, Kartika, Sharon, Amelin, Desira, Claudia, and Fincy, her sister. The dance you have all seen is basically a compilation of Aileen's signature poses that we have put together for the newlywed. When we were kindergarten, way before we could even understand what friendship even means. Throughout our SPH days, she was my go-to lunchbox friend because she definitely had the most awesome lunchbox meals. I can never forget the cute octopus-looking sausages, perfect egg rolls, and delicious beef udon. I truly feel blessed that despite the long distances and growing up in different environments all these years, we still managed to remain the best of friends.
Hi everyone, my name is Jeff. For those of you who don't know me, I'm John's older brother. A little bit nervous, probably drank a little bit too much before this speech, but most of my anxiety was actually this morning. I was really worried about whether I could even fit into my pants. So, yeah, thankfully that's done with. Yeah, it's great to be a part of the happiest day in my brother's life, this wedding.
Come in, guys.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Alaric Joyo Nagoro, and I am one of John's cousin and groomsmen.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Bro Jonah Goral, and I am also his groomsman, but not only that, I'm his cousin.
My name is Suryadi. I'm also one of John's groomsmen and cousins.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Otto. I'm John's brother-in-law, and I'm his groomsman too.
So in this time-honored tradition, we're going to do our best to give John the most uncomfortable 5 minutes of his life.
We'd also like to congratulate the bridesmaids on doing a fantastic job today and who look absolutely stunning. They are only surpassed, of course, by the gorgeous bride, Aileen, who I'm sure you'll all agree looks breathtaking today.
From the way you smile to the way you look, you capture me. Unlike no other, from the first hello, yeah, that's all it took.
As many of you probably already know, behind that long, slender, and sexy hot bod, Aileen is also into comic, anime, and gaming, which I personally think makes her the coolest package ever. You're lucky, John.
Don't ever think I need more. I've got the one to live for. No one else will do. And I'm telling you, just put your heart in my hands. Promise it won't get broken. We'll never forget this moment. Yeah, we'll stay brand new. Cause I love you.
Aileen also was over the one and who over again. To comic and anime. Our friendship revolves so much around time limit and slam dunk that we retardedly associated much of our life to it.
Chicken wing?
Nonetheless, Lynn, I truly am grateful about many things that you've taught and grew alongside with me all these years. From delicious food, hobbies, loving a dog, to growing in God and true friendship. Most important of all today, I want to thank you for choosing me to be one of your bridesmaids and witness your hand in marriage with John, a wonderful, caring man hidden behind that cuek attitude.
Over and over again. So don't ever think I need more.
I look forward to creating many more memories with you, John and Latte, laughing and rolling on the floor of your new home.
Promise it won't get broken. We'll never forget this moment. Yeah, we'll stay brand new. Cause I love you.
So Aileen and I first met in Mrs. Bloom's art class in 7th grade, Jizz. And as fate would have it, Aileen's first day of school, she met me. And she happened to sit next to me. And she spoke heavy Towo accent.
When I'm with you, I lose track.
Nonetheless,
of time.
We hit it off because we were both obsessed with slam dunk. So of course from here we joined basketball together, and we also started taking Japanese class with a sensei called Mr. Gustavo.
I've got the one to live for. No one else will do. Yeah, I'm telling you. Just put your heart in my hand.
But this was the start of our friendship, and promise all throughout the years, Aileen's been a partner of mine in whatever I was passionate about. Up to this day, she is my diving buddy. And for those of you who know Aileen well enough, know that beneath this beautiful exterior is a silly, goofy, and animated girl. She makes the weirdest noise sometimes, describing things in her own language that we eventually get after knowing her all these years. For example, one day, Aileen wanted to drink hot tea because it's hey. And us girls, knowing Aileen so well at this point, understood that hey meant soothing or comforting.
Follow me down to the shore. We could cast our sails.
John was a sweet and quiet little boy. Until he discovered alcohol.
John does not like to smile in photos. Unless it is a photo with Aileen.
Can the waves.
It's for John. He's the heart of the family. He's the guy that everybody just likes. The guy that gets stuff done. So last year, when I moved back from Jakarta and moved into the family home, I mentioned to him that I wasn't getting internet in my room. The next day, boom, he got Wi-Fi and cable TV installed. I mean, this is a small example, but I believe these kinds of everyday gestures reveal someone's true character. And that's the kind of guy my brother is, a good man.
Here is where we decide.
I've said in
some. This animated character of hers became a trademark, and it is what we love and adore about Aileen. Anyway, after going back to the past, here we are celebrating Aileen and John's love for each other. And I know that this is the real deal. Because after following your relationship over the years, I can see that you guys become better people as individuals. Even better than you already are before. I still can't believe that my best friend is now married. I'm so happy for you guys. I hope you stay kind to each other and always choose love. I wish you happiness in your journey ahead.
Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It's not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil but rejoices with the truth. It always protects. Love never fails.
Hi everyone, I'm Sharon, part of the Bridesmaids team. So my friend right here has such unique drunken behavior, which involves some eye rolling and some grabbing of her friend's physical parts. All of which are exclusive to us, and I will not explain further. But besides all those unique behavior of hers, she is still my go-to drinking buddy. Lynn, I appreciate you trying to get me drunk all the time, which unfortunately still fails till now. But I truly appreciate you for always being there for me whenever I feel like having a drink, which was back then quite often. You were my wing girl and will always be. And thanks for all those funny drunken memories. John, you are so lucky to have this girl. Not only that she has the hot, sexy bod, but you will get a loyal lifetime companion with a beautiful personality. Congrats again to the new Mr. and Mrs. Yuono.
I think I should tell you a bit more about what John is like in his younger days. So in high school, he tried really hard to be a badass, and note the word try. Together is better with you. listened to gangster rap, and he told everyone he was part of a gang called 369. which of course is really a bunch of pimply kids pretending to be in a gang. I mean, Jiang over there was also part of 369. And this is the guy who goes to church mission trips and sings Hillsong. Every star and it hangs on your voice. For your word never
returns void. Hun, what a journey it has been. 5 years ago when you told me you liked me, I was really, really excited. I did mini jumping jacks at 5 a.m. in Claudia's bathroom. That excitement quickly turned into many uphills and downhills. We fought so much, sometimes I wonder what the heck for. But now I'm glad that we, time and time again, always committed and found our way back to each other. It makes me believe we can overcome and achieve anything together. One year ago, that time when I suddenly showed up at your house crying, you didn't question me why, but instead you gave me a big hug. And you told me, it's okay, I will always be there for you, and I will always take care of you. You have no idea how overwhelmed I was, how grateful I am to have you. I want to say thank you for who you are, for your loving, big heart, and for taking me as I am. You have no idea how happy you have made me feel this past 5 years. Thank you for making today a reality.
Please welcome father of the groom, Mr. John Lin Yuono, and sister of the groom, Miss Genevieve Yuono.
Everyone, my name is Vinci and I'm Aileen's sister. Before Aileen and John met, Aileen often told me how much she wanted to meet a guy whom she can truly fall in love with and whom she can feel proud of. Well, she has a couple more criteria, mainly being manly, smart, and good-hearted. Well, 5 years ago, God answered her prayer when she met John.
For those who don't know me or whom I haven't had yet the pleasure to meet, my name is Dirk. John and I grew up together in Singapore. The thought hadn't crossed my mind about how long we've actually known each other until he asked me to do this. And John and I have known each other for 24 years now, and I realized 24 years is a really long time.
John, the moment you came along, you literally shook Eileen's world upside down. You may or may not know this, but before, she wasn't very fond of karaoke. Now she sings duet with you and even patiently waits for you when you hog the mic.
Throughout these 24 years, John has always been a very loyal and constant friend.
I've never seen her so happy until you. I've never seen her talk about any guy the way she talked about you. Eyes twinkling, always with a bit of excitement. Never heard her talk so much and nonstop about a guy until you.
Aileen, although I may not have known you for nearly as long, I know from the moment I met you that you make John extremely happy and that you are the one. And I mean that sincerely and from the bottom of my heart. There was something the way you complimented each other, or maybe it was the way you laughed at John's bad jokes, or most of all, the uncanny patience you've been gifted with.
My brother and I, you know, we're quite different. You know, he loves his body. I love burgers and pizza. I thought Guardians of the Galaxy was awesome. He'd rather watch You've Got Mail. So we're different, but we do agree on one thing, and that's that Aileen was the best thing that ever happened to him.
Please welcome to entering the wedding dinner area, Mr. Jonathan Iwono and Mrs. Aileen Wong Sudarwo.
That basketball cupcake she baked for you, and that bento box, and the many other handmade stuff that I probably don't even know of. And I say those are just her little fun expression or token of her love for you.
Hi, I'm Emmeline. So me and Aileen are actually quite different. I'm super OCD, and Aileen is more spontaneous.
For those of you who don't know John before he met Aileen, he was actually quite antisocial, right? He would stay home all day, all night. Doesn't want to go out, would rather just watch TV, watch EPL games, drink whiskey by himself. It was a little sad. It was like the Asian male versions of Bridget Jones.
To God, happiness and special moments. Cheers. God bless.
It's the best thing that I'll ever do. I get to love you. It's a promise I'm making to you. Whatever may come, your heart I will choose. Forever I'm yours, forever I do. I get to love you.
We've been close friends for more than half of our lives. She was always there for me when I needed her. We had this book in high school. This one.
John, I have said in my last speech that I was unwilling to let Aileen go. Well, I realize I can no longer hold that sentiment. Looking at you both today, I realize that you both have charted your own course for the future. You and Aileen are one unit now. I realized how essential it is for both of you to spend the rest of your life to have and to hold on to each other. Most of all, I realize that you are the only person who could truly make Aileen happy.
I get to love you. It's the best thing that I'll ever do. I get to love you.
Thank you so much for being such a wonderful friend all these years. I wrote a few words for you in the book as you go through this next phase, very exciting in your life. I'm so happy you and John have found each other, and I wish you guys the best.
I get to love you. I get to love you. I get to love you. I get to love you.
But that's how I knew Aileen was the one, because once they met and started dating, he was a changed man. Started socializing again, he got a new haircut, bought new clothes, went to trendy restaurants. I mean, the guy even started going to church. So Aileen, you did in a few months what I couldn't do in 34 years. You made my brother a better man. Thank you.
As you two embark onto your voyage into the great unknown, I know that your mutual respect, love, admiration, and most importantly, trust in one another will navigate you through any challenge life can throw at you. I have no doubt that you two have what it takes to survive any storm. I also think I speak on behalf of this crew when I say that you two are not alone in this journey. That every broken heart
knows we were walking on. So, as Dirk mentioned, we've known John for a really long time. It's been over 20 years at this point. And I'm sure it's no surprise to a lot of you. John is extremely supportive, somebody who is driven, dedicated, and a fiercely loyal friend. I have no question that these attributes are going to serve both of you well in your marriage.
Aileen was even known in Boston and was called as Boston Goddess. During those years, so many guys wanted to get to know Aileen. But beyond her beautiful self and her quirky personality, really the one thing that you have to know is that Aileen really has a caring heart. Aileen was there for me through my most difficult moments, and I will never forget that.
As you both step into this marriage, you will experience God's love more and more, and your marriage will not simply be a union between husband and wife, but it will embrace a partnership with God.
You probably heard this, but John, the secret to a happy marriage is give and take. Give and take. Aileen gives the orders, you take them. Aileen, apparently a new husband is like tiled floor. You lay it right the first time, and you can spend years walking all over it.
There is no such thing as a perfect match nor a perfect marriage. But in that non-perfect marriage is where you will find God's perfect love. It has been such a joyful day witnessing you two get married. I praise God for putting you two together, and I'm excited to see God's glory to be shown off in your marriage. So congratulations, guys. So I'm gonna love.
You have grown and matured so much into this strong, confident young lady, ready to embrace her future with the one she loves. And that is so clearly reflected in you today. In my last speech, I expressed how much I miss and agonize letting go the little you from the past. But today, I look at you in awe. I truly admire you for confidently and wholeheartedly committing to this marriage.
I'm gonna love you. I'm gonna love you.
spend the rest of your life with. And from the bottom of my heart, I just want to say that I'm very happy for the both of you. Congratulations, Aileen and John. I love you both so much. God bless your marriage.
You always ask me how much I love you. This is such a silly question. The reality is that I love you so much and cannot see myself spending the rest of my life with anybody else and sharing the good and bad times with. As my wife, I vow to always share the good and best times of my life with you.
Now it's my turn to say, I vow to always be there for you, and I vow to always take care of you. I choose to be your partner for life. I know I'm not the perfect wife material. I'm stubborn as a rock. I'm clumsy. I have problems with time management. I can be picky with my food. But don't worry, as long as you have eggs in your fridge, I will be okay.
I cannot promise riches, blissful happiness, or perfect health. But even in your lowest and weakest moments, I will be there for you as your husband, best friend, and lifelong partner. After today, we will face so many struggles and challenges, but knowing that you are by my side, I know that we can face anything together. You and me, King and Queen, Jon Snow and Daenerys Targaryen, we own the world. Everything else is just noise. As my wife, I vow to love you every day, and each and every day moving forward, I will try to be the better man for you.
In the past 5 years, your strength of character has really showed through in many occasions. I respect and admire you a lot as someone who makes good decisions, someone who has a good head, and a big heart. And though you may not look like it, I know deep down you care a lot for people around you.
We don't thank him enough for his blessings. Everything we have, you and me, is from him. I want to be the spiritual leader that I know I can be. I just need you to help me get there. As my wife, I vow to be the spiritual leader that I know I can be. I love you.
I also know that once you put your mind to something, you will commit. And so I have faith you can achieve anything if you want. So I promise to support you and your dreams, always. I promise to always keep you in my prayers, even when you're really annoying. I promise to try my best to listen to your advice, to learn the ways of life together with you, and to bear your burden when it gets hard. I will continue to celebrate your triumphs and mourn your losses as though they were mine. Build a loving home with you, for Latte, and future new members of our family. I look forward to growing old together with you in love and in faith. As I have given you my hand to hold, so I give you my life to keep. I love you very much.